Success is one of the possible outcomes, and I always thought about it when you started Endeavor. If you make Blue Origin a private aerospace company, success must be at least one of the possible outcomes of a large-scale rocket launch. Decade of development, Jeff Bezos's Blue Origin is still running into technical problems with its engine. One Blue Origin's powerful B-4 rocket engines suffered a dramatic failure during testing last month. This is not only a destructive setback for Blue Origin, but also a major hurdle for EULA's Vulcan launch vehicle. This begs the question, what happened to Blue Origin? Let's discuss it today in this episode of Science of Space. Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin space venture confirmed that one of its B-4 rocket engines suffered a significant anomaly during testing at its West Texas facility in late June. The incident first came to light today in a report from CNBC, which quoted unnamed sources as saying that the engine detonated about 10 seconds into a test firing on June 30. CNBC said the engine was meant to be used for the second launch of United Launch Alliance's next-generation Vulcan rocket. That launch, known as CERT-2, is meant to send Sierra Space's Dream Chaser space plane on an uncrewed cargo delivery mission to the International Space Station. Blue Origin already has delivered two B-4 engines to EULA for the first Vulcan launch, CERT-1, which is tasked with deploying the first two prototype satellites for Amazon's Project Kuiper broadband network into low Earth orbit, as well as sending Astrobotics' robotic lunar lander on its way to the Moon. Getting Blue Origin's B-4 engines ready for their first launch has already taken years longer than Blue Origin or EULA anticipated when they announced the rocket development project in 2014. The B-4 is designed to use liquefied natural gas as fuel and provide 550,000 pounds of thrust with deep throttle capability. The engines are to be used not only on Vulcan's first stage booster, but also on Blue Origin's orbital class New Glenn rocket, which is expected to have its first launch no earlier than 2024. Blue Origin has already struck deals for multiple satellite launches using New Glenn, and NASA plans to use New Glenn for the launch of twin spacecraft to Mars in late 2024. If it takes longer than Blue Origin anticipates to address the issues raised by last month's test failure, that could have a domino effect on those missions. Meanwhile, the first Vulcan launch has been delayed due to a completely different issue. A fiery anomaly that EULA experienced during testing of the Vulcan rocket's Centaur V upper stage in March. EULA says it's modifying the upper stage to address issues raised by that anomaly, which did not involve the B-4 rocket engine. United Launch Alliance's CEO, Tory Bruno, discussed the June 30 incident in a series of tweets. The failure of the engine's acceptance test, or ATP, was way less interesting than it sounds, he said. They happen. That's why we acceptance test each component coming off the line before accepting delivery, Bruno said. He said he was very confident that the failure of the test was due to poor workmanship on that particular engine, rather than an overlooked flaw in the engine design. Bezos almost never speaks with space journalists about the company's activities, and the new Shepard 23 investigation is no exception. Blue Origin has made no public statements about the failure. It is investigating or planning the next flight. The question is whether this will be an uncrewed or crewed aircraft. Blue Origin was flying two different New Shepard systems at the time of the accident. The RSSHG Wells capsule was flying science missions on Booster 3, and the newer RSS First Step was flying crewed missions on Booster 4. The company's oldest operational rocket, Booster 3, which launched the failed mission in September, made its debut on December 2, 2017. Blue Origin could choose to fly a rudimentary mission on Booster 4, and an uncrewed test flight on the rocket, or debut a new booster with modification. Made as a result of the lessons learned from the latest Shepard 23 accident investigation. The company has used its newest rocket Booster 4, exclusively for human launches. It has some modifications from Booster 3 to qualify as a human-rated rocket. According to Gary Lyne, the chief architect for the new Shepard at Blue Origin, who said that in February, Blue Origin would support about a few dedicated payload missions a year. The same as it has even as the number of private payload missions increases, dedicated payload flights will become less common in the future. These flights have carried more than 100 commercial payloads. While there is less space on the propulsion module for payload, the companies offering new research opportunities also include flying payloads on the new Shepard's propulsion module. Something, he said, can be done on both research and tourism flights. He also mentioned that there will be an option to allow payloads to be exposed for sampling the atmosphere or even deploy instruments. Another novel option is a low-gravity flight, in which the crew capsule is spun after deployment to simulate lunar gravity for a brief period of time. The company is also working with NASA to fly government researchers and astronauts through the agency's suborbital crew program. Blue Origin is looking at options for human-tended experiments, according to Lai, such as replacing seats with experiment racks. The company is also looking at updates to the new Shepard, though Lai said that changes would focus on operations and the customers likely. Do you want a high-priced seat on the new Shepard? I most emphatically do not, but I am considering SpaceX's Dragon. One of the most significant differences between the two spacecraft is that the SpaceX Dragon can fly in orbit, whereas the new Shepards are only designed for suborbital flight. The Dragon's ability to achieve orbit allows it to perform more complex missions, such as resupplying the ISS, conducting scientific experiments in space, and launching satellites into available orbit. Moreover, while the new Shepard is still attempting to conceal its failures, Dragons have sent 8 crews into orbit, and in a little more than 2 years. SpaceX has surpassed the total number of astronauts not launched into orbit by China, whose human space flight program dates back to 2003. And in the time the Crew Dragon's been operational, it has exceeded even the Russian Soyuz vehicles, in terms of the total number of people flown into space. During that period, SpaceX Dragon has safely returned the US's capability of human space flight, which had been lost since the space shuttle retirement, and Dragon not been available. So we are saving a ton of money on the high end, while we're still managing to utilize the commercial prices on the low end. The military hopes that by opening Lane 1, it will be able to nurture still more competitors for high-value missions later in the 2030s. And it appears that the newer US launch companies all have such aspirations. As we talk to the Rocket Labs, Relativities, the ABLs, they all talk about how they're expanding from their smaller launch focus into medium lift, Pentecost said. And everybody has plans to go even higher. Balancing range demand. One sign of the emergence of new competitors, as well as SpaceX and potentially United Launch Alliance ramping up their launch frequency, is the usage of the Eastern and Western ranges, operated by the U.S. Space Force. The Eastern range encompasses Cape Canaveral and Kennedy Space Center, in Florida, as well as Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia. The Western range includes Vandenberg Space Force Base, and other U.S. launch sites in the Pacific. Pentecost shared the following data about increasing launch cadence at both ranges, as well as a projection for this year. One of the reasons why they selected SpaceX is because they placed the Europa Clipper in Category 3 for launch services. This means that the Europa Clippers should be carried on a commercial vehicle that has performed at least 3 successful launches. This put the Falcon Heavy miles above competing commercial rockets. You see, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy was successfully flown 3 times, despite not being launched since 2019. Other competing vehicles such as United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur and Blue Origin's New Glenn haven't even had their first launches.